discorsi più o meno di questi a seguito e dal answer to your question at the end of autumn. So now we are at the first step of our pavilion, and this one is the atomic clock. This one, it was realized by the Italian company Leonardo. It has an error of only 1 second every 3 million years. So for this reason, you will reach the perfect time, of course. It works understanding the movement of the atoms and works already in 26 satellites into the space. This one is something like a comparison between the old system to count the time, this one, the less hour, and then, of course, the new system, the atomic clock. But if you want to follow me to the next phase of our pavilion, thank you very much. Installation that is our tribute to the United Arab Emirates, because there are 50 lines like the protege of the United Arab Emirates divided in 7 blocks. 7 blocks like the 7 entrants that found in the United Arab Emirates in 1971, of course. On your right side, you can start to see the exhibition called the Italian Genial, Smart Italy. As you can see, it went there from the ground floor. Then, on your left side, there is this one, this is the Gillian Trotter. It's something like an helicopter and an airplane together. So, it can go as an helicopter, up and down, and it could be a fast and an airplane. And it was realized in the same company of the okay, let's wait for everyone. Thank you very much. Please come closer. Thank you. Okay, what are these numbers? If you add 1 plus 1, we give to you 2. 1 plus 2, we give to you 3. 3 plus 2, we give to you 5, and so on. This one is the Fibonacci series. Fibonacci was Italian, and it represents the circularity of the nature. But why we have the Fibonacci series here? Because we are reaching the part of our pavilion that we call the Mediterranean area. So, circularity of nature, then Mediterranean area, Mediterranean. So please follow me and let's reach together. On your right side, you can start to see the Mediterranean area. I will explain it to you at the end of the skywalk. Okay, please make a little group right here. Let's wait for the group and we will give an over to the conference. Thank you very much. Okay, let's wait here. Thank you. So, this one is the area that I told you before, the Mediterranean area. Why? Because there are something like two islands, Middle Island, the big island, and then the sea. The sea, of course, is not a sea, and I think that you are wondering why the water is green. The water is green because it's a cultivation of spirulina algae. Spirulina is really good because it's considered by the FAO superfood of the future, because it has a lot of beneficial properties. Think that a little part of spirulina is something like 1 kilo of fruit and vegetables. But with spirulina you can do also cosmetic and paint. The bubbles are here because spirulina is transforming the dioxin in oxygen and light for their photosynthesis process, of course. The Little Island is the laboratory by Tolobin that studies everything about spirulina, every day and every night, also when the pavilion is closed. So they work more than me, maybe. Then there is this building, this one, that is called Belvedere. Belvedere in Italian means the place where you see the beauty. And when we get inside, we see the landscapes of the Italian region. So Belvedere, a place where you see the beauty, and of course, Italy. The building outside is made of dry stone wall. That is a technique that became 3 years ago UNESCO. But please follow me and let's enjoy our journey in Italy. So please welcome to the Vedere. You can stand also beside for everyone to enter. Thank you very much. Okay, let everyone enter. Thank you. So, as I told you, the outside is made of dry stone wall, but when we get inside the Belvedere, we see that the style changes, no? Because the apart reminds us the cupola of the Pantheon in Rome, our capital city, our amazing capital city. Then the bottom part reminds one of the most important era of our history, the Renaissance, the Rinascimento. In the circle, there are the Italian paintings, the Italian styles, by Giotto and Mantegna, and then there are the short movies about the Italian regions that was filmed by the Italian film director Gabriele Salvatore, who won also an Oscar Prize with a movie called Mediterraneo, and we are into the Mediterranean area of our pavilion, of course. But now there is a region in the south of Italy that is called Basilicata. But please follow me to the next station of our pavilion. Okay, please come closer, thank you. Okay, we wait for the last part of the group. Let me run away, of course, because this one is an area that is called short stories and it will change every week thanks to the thematical weeks of Expo. This one was the week of the design, so there is an exhibition called Italia Geniale, powered by the Italian Ministry of Development, and show the best of the Italian brands related to design. For example, here we have the iconic Vespa, of course, but I want you to pay attention to this one. This one is the very first machine that was sent to space for the astronauts. So they had a very important and very good Italian breakfast, of course. This one. And if you follow me to this side, there is the card right here, this one. Okay. Let's wait for the group. Okay, this one is not a normal garden. It's not the garden of my grandfather, of course. It's a special garden because it's something like a big experiment that will last for the entire period of the Expo. There are 119 plants from the Mediterranean area, and we are studying if this plant can live or not in a desertical climate like one of the United Arab Emirates. How we can do it? Because every plant has this one, this sensor, this chip, that links the plant to the National Research Center in Rome. So they from Rome have all the big data about the plant, if the plant is going well or not, if it needs water or not. And if the experiment will go good, it will be really good for them. Thank you.